Do you want to see how to create designs inside of Adobe Spark like this? In today's video, I'm going to show you how only using the text tool. What's up, guys? Thanks for clicking on this video. My name is Nate Hibbert, and this is Wingman University, where our goal is to help you start and scale a print-on-demand business. So like I said, in today's video, we're going to be talking about the text tool. I'm going to show you guys how to add text, how to manipulate text, and show you a simple design you can make with only text. So let's go ahead and jump in. So here we are inside of Adobe Spark. We've got our artboard all ready to go in the proper sizing and our toolbox over here on the right-hand side. And to add text, we just have to use this big add button that's represented by this plus symbol in the top right. We're going to click on that and select text. Now, it's going to give you a few templates you can choose from, but today we're going to be starting from scratch, so we can hit this button that says add your own text. Once we do that, it's going to give us a box that we can fill in. And today's design, I'm going to make something very simple, and it's just going to say, I like coffee more than you. Capitalize the L on coffee. Hit done, and then that is going to populate inside of our artboard. So it is that easy to add text to your artboard, and then you can start manipulating it. So as you just saw, I can grab these little white handles and I can resize it. And when I resize it, sometimes it will move words between the lines. Now, because when I was creating this text, I actually hit enter, these lines will never move. But if I open this back up by double clicking in here and put this all on one line, you can see that I can manipulate it a lot more with just those white handles. So if I do that, hit done, then I use these white handles and move this all on one line, it will put it all on one line. Or if I make this box a little bit taller, then every word will have its own line. So there's lots of manipulating you can do very quickly just by using these white handles. And there's even more we can do with the text box, or the toolbox, excuse me, over here on the right-hand side. So this is really where you're going to be able to manipulate your text and do things like change the font. There's a bunch of free fonts already built in that we can use commercial free, which is very nice of Adobe to include that. We can do things like change the color here. It will suggest colors, but it also has a bunch of preset colors that we can choose from. We have the shapes, all these different shapes that can go behind it. So right now there's this just box behind here, but we can change it to a rounded box or just these two brackets on the top and bottom. So there's lots of built-in functionality already inside of here. There's effects that we can do, things like adding shadows and stroke, or as they call it here, an outline. And then the style tool is probably my favorite and one of the great things about Spark, which is a way to get inspiration very quickly. You can type in whatever you want, come down here to the style tab and spin this little green circle around the gray path, and it's going to just populate a bunch of different looks and designs and backgrounds and fonts for you, just to feel inspired. And then you can come back in and you can change whatever you would like about that. If you know, you want more spacing in between your lines, you can go in and do that. So it's all very quick. Now, if I was going to use this for my print-on-demand business, I would make a few changes. I think the random generator did a good job, but I want to take it the rest of the way. So I am going to break this out onto each line again so I can have more control over that. I like coffee and you being on their own lines. I'm actually going to go in and remove this background. I kind of like the font though, so I will leave the font for at least I like and more than you. But I think what I'm going to do is a little bit more stylized, and I'm going to use the secondary text style. And I'm going to be able to click on the words coffee and you, unclick I, and that's going to make these two lines that I can manipulate them separately from the I like and more than you. So I'm going to change this font to something else, maybe something a little cursive, something a little bit more playful. Let's see if we can find something we like quickly. All right, I'm a fan of this one. It's called True North. So I'm going to go back to our primary and spread this out. Again, I want I like coffee and more than you all on separate lines. And the color for the secondary, I do not want to be pink. That is very bold and in your face. So I'm just going to turn that to white and turn off that outline that we added by going up here and saying none. And the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to actually turn off capitalize and fit on the primary because I want coffee and you to stand out more than I like. So I can go back in here, make sure that it's all on one line, and then there we go. We have our design the way that I would like it, emphasizing coffee and you, and over I like and more than. But that it would be a simple design that we could put on a shirt, and maybe even change the background stroke color of this, or just turn that off and turn that to maybe like a brown. So we go back in here, but you can see that there's a lot of things you can do to manipulate this text very quickly. So I like this layout, but I'm going to keep fiddling with this. And if you'd like to learn more, we have a video playlist for you on tips and tricks specifically for Spark, and another one how I'm actually using this tool for our print on demand business. And both of those will be over here. Until the next video, I'll see you guys around.